This hour-long edition of KETV News Watch 7 at 10 continues with the return of Space Shuttle Endeavour. It touched down in Florida just over an hour ago. Now, during their 13-day mission, the astronauts delivered a room, an observation deck to the International Space Station. NASA is canceling the shuttle program at the end of this year. A local man has piloted the Endeavour twice and was commander of the Space Shuttle Atlantis.
His career has gone to even greater heights. 55-year-old Kevin Chilton is the first astronaut to become a four-star general. He's also the head of U.S. STRATCOM, a command charged with helping protect our nation on a number of fronts. Well, tonight, a rare chance to talk one-on-one with the general.
So this tile flew on the very first flight of Endeavour.
General Kevin Chilton has an office full, a career full of memories.
This is the second flight where we carried the radar up to study the Earth.
The former test pilot and shuttle commander is making more memories. The four-star general is in charge of United States Strategic Command.
We really have a global mission focus.
Recently, I had the opportunity to meet with Chilton in his office, secured in STRATCOM headquarters at Offutt Air Force Base. The multiple branch operation has multiple missions in cyberspace, in deterring nuclear attacks on the U.S., and in space.
What we provide to other military operations around the world through space is absolutely critical to their operations.
For example, in the wars in Afghanistan and Iraq, in remote areas, the military relies heavily on these Predator drones. They're unmanned aircraft being steered by pilots at a base in Nevada over satellites controlled by STRATCOM.
You cannot imagine doing operations in Iraq and Afghanistan without the support of the United States Strategic Command Space Forces.
Now, without getting too specific, General Chilton says STRATCOM has other missions, as seen in this video provided by the military. Missile defense, fighting weapons of mass destruction, and supporting surveillance and reconnaissance commands around the world.
But day in and day out, if a bad thing happens in space, cyberspace, or in the nuclear deterrent business, that phone on my desk is going to ring.
A lot of the bad things in space? Junk. Remnants of man-made objects. And satellites that are key to military operations with things like GPS and weather forecasting are in danger from the debris. STRATCOM tries to keep them from colliding, but that's getting harder to do.
We've seen the amount of particles that we and objects we can track grow from somewhere around 8,000 to over 20,000 now. So we're trending in the wrong direction as far as the creation of debris in the orbits that are close to the Earth.
3, 2, 1.
And Chilton's seen it firsthand, flying the shuttle three times, beginning in 1992.
Liftoff of the maiden voyage of Endeavour on a satellite rescue mission.
You watch you go from 0 miles per hour sitting on the launch pad to almost 18,000 miles an hour in 8.5 minutes. That sense of power that's behind you is pretty awesome.
His career has been powered by a drive to go high, go fast.
Here's the bolt that comes up through the launch pad.
And while he says he mostly flies a desk now, even one with NASA mementos.
Two explosive charges are thread into these slots here.
Like parts from the launch pad.
These things are fired and the nut splits apart.
General Chilton wants people to realize that while the rich military tradition at Offutt continues, it continues in a new world.
That this isn't SAC anymore. This is the United States Strategic Command, and it's a command that still does that very important deterrence mission for the United States, and we stay focused on that. But we're doing more now, more than ever, in some really exciting mission areas.
Well, Chilton says one of the things that helps make STRATCOM successful is the support it gets from the metro. People of the area looking out for the morale and welfare of those in the military.
Great interview. It's so cool to see somebody who's done and seen so much and is still
right here
doing all of that. Yeah. Yep. Thanks, Rob.